Freedom Scientific, a Vispero brand.
An introduction to Windows 11 and JAWS. Let's now take a look at the taskbar and the taskbar overflow icon settings. As Liz mentioned in the beginning of this training, the taskbar has moved. It used to appear in Windows 10 on the left lower side of the screen. The taskbar icons are now in the middle, and the taskbar is locked to the bottom of the screen at all times. There are ways to change this, but no simple ways at this time that we can recommend. As I tab through, I'll say again the same thing Liz did, that my desktop is going to be slightly different. I've already made some setting changes for Windows 11, and I'll show you what those are. Let's look for the taskbar overflow settings. I'm going to press the start menu and go into search.
Search box edit. T A S K task manager at B taskbar settings system settings. Press right to switch preview.
I'll press enter here.
Enter. Settings search box. Find a setting edit.
And I will tab and show you some of the settings that I have already changed.
Personalization 4 of 11. Personalization button.
I'm going to keep tabbing.
Taskbar items. Show all settings button expanded.
As you heard JAWS say, my settings are expanded. So if they're not, you can press right arrow or enter, and it should expand those settings so that you're able to tab through them.
Search button on.
This is the option to actually turn off the search, edit, and the start button. Of course, I want to leave that on.
Task view button on. Widgets button off.
All right. So earlier, Liz mentioned that widgets were one of the new features in Windows 11, and we are going to be exploring those further coming up in our additional training. But currently, I have this turned off so that widgets do not appear on my taskbar. The widgets board is currently toggled to off.
Chat button off.
I also likewise have the chat turned off. So I use Microsoft Teams for work. Currently, chat is toggled off because we will be exploring that further in our next training as well, but currently I'm not using it.
Taskbar corner icons, show all settings button expanded.
All right, so this is the taskbar corner overflow, AKA the system tray. And this is where you'll see a lot of status information about different applications as well as your system. So I'm gonna continue to tab.
List box, pan menu, 1 of 3. Pan menu button, on. Taskbar corner overflow, show all settings button collapsed.
I'm going to expand this with enter.
Enter, expanded. List box, Zoom meetings, 1 of 12.
And you will hear some of the items that currently appear on my taskbar overflow.
Zoom meetings button, on.
And if I did not want to see these, I could just toggle them to off with the spacebar.
Taskbar behaviors, show all settings button collapsed. Space, expanded. Taskbar alignment combo box, center.
Here I can change this, as I mentioned. You can, if you liked visually, for your taskbar to be docked onto the lower left side of the screen. This is where you would change this. I'm just going to continue to go through these settings.
Automatically hide the taskbar checkbox not checked. Show badges unread messages counter on taskbar apps checkbox checked.
So also in Windows 11, you have the options for your taskbar icons to have badges. And this is just a checkbox that you would uncheck if you do not want those badges to appear.
Show desktop button checkbox checked. Get help, give feedback link.
Those are just some of the settings that appear in the taskbar corner overflow icons area. And you can still access this with insert F11.
Alt F4, desktop.
If you're using JAWS. Let's try that, insert F11.
Select a system tray icon dialog. Select a system tray icon list box. Notification chevron, Zoom, 2 of 9. Dropbox, 138.
So as you can hear, the sound of that hasn't changed and it still functions the same as far as JAWS is concerned when it comes to the system tray list and using insert F11.
Escape, fold.
So that is just a little bit about some of the semantics changes and the way that settings have changed in Windows 11 when it comes to the taskbar, what's on it, its location, how to shut off widgets and chat, and then how to manage the icons that appear in the lower right-hand corner of the screen, which are our system tray or taskbar overflow icons. And lastly, just a quick reminder that you can find all of the Windows accessibility tools no longer under the Ease of Access Center, but under accessibility settings. So if you were someone who opened the search menu and typed in Ease, E-A-S-E, like I did for a long, long time, just a reminder
search box edit.
That you'll now type accessibility,
A-C-C-E-S-S, access, amp, press right to switch
and I'll
preview,
press down arrow.
Find results in apps, Dolby Access, control panel, amp, NVIDIA control, find results in settings, access remote app and desktops, access worker school, accessibility keyboard settings, system settings, press right to switch preview.
And you could, of course, type the entire word and it would be closer to the top of your list. But if I press enter here,
enter, settings, sticky, filter, and toggle keys.
And of course, I opened up the specific settings for keyboard accessibility, but you can find all of the normal settings you would expect, including ways to make your mouse more visible or your cursor more visible, or change some of your keyboard settings under the Accessibility Center in Windows 11.
Freedom Scientific, a Vispero brand. To stay up to date on upcoming webinars and training events, complete the sign-up form at freedomscientific.com/webinars. Thanks again for connecting with us.